Hi friends, so in a previous video, I explained what walk-forward optimization is and why you should include it as part of your strategy development workflow. Since then, some of you have asked whether there is an objective way to determine the optimal test settings. I hope to answer that question in this video, starting with a brief recap of what walk-forward optimization is.
The process involves breaking down your data into numerous segments, each containing an in-sample and out-of-sample portion. For each segment, strategy optimizations are conducted over the in-sample portion, after which the optimal parameters are applied to the out-of-sample portion. There are two key settings when setting up a walk-forward optimization. First is the number of optimization runs. This is the number of times each in-sample optimization and out-of-sample testing cycle is done. There are 10 runs in the illustration here. The next is your out-of-sample percentage. For each run, this is the out-of-sample data length in comparison to the in-sample length. A 20% out-of-sample percent is used here. These two settings can completely change the complexion of your optimization. With the current settings, we get a backtest starting from 2009. If we instead use 30 runs and a 40% out-of-sample percent, we get a much longer out-of-sample test from 2005. In general, the more runs you have, the less likely it is that your results are due to chance, but more runs also means more frequent parameter re-optimizations. Likewise, a larger out-of-sample percent produces a longer overall out-of-sample test. But if it's too large, you will likely have too few trades in the optimization period for a reliable estimate of the optimal strategy parameters. So how do you settle on a favorable setting? StrategyQuant's walk-forward matrix has the answer. Let's say you want your number of runs to be in the 10 to 30 range and the out-of-sample percent to be in the 10 to 40 range. In essence, StrategyQuant's walk-forward matrix lets you simultaneously optimize these parameters when running the traditional walk-forward optimization. You get a 20-cell matrix, with each cell corresponding to a particular walk-forward setting. Notice that each cell has its own robustness score. This is the percentage of walk-forward metrics that pass your filters. For example, if you want a walk-forward efficiency of at least 50% and at least 70% of runs to be profitable, you will get a 100% robustness score if both conditions pass. If instead, only one condition passes, you will get a 50% robustness score. At this point, you may be wondering whether optimizing your walk-forward settings, in addition to the strategy's parameters themselves, could be excessive. In general, the more optimizing you do, the less robust your trading solution. To compensate for this, StrategyQuant implements an additional robustness filter, whereby the test only passes when there is a stable range of parameters. For this 20-cell matrix, it's typical to look for a 9-cell region in which at least 7 cells have a 100% robustness score. If this stable region is present, usually the cell in the middle will yield the optimal walk-forward settings. Therefore, by examining your strategy's stability when exposed to different WFO settings, the WFM provides another layer of robustness tests while helping you select optimal WFO settings. Next up is a step-by-step guide on how to set up StrategyQuant's walk-forward matrix. The strategy I'll use should be familiar to supporters of the channel. It's a pound yen weekly breakout strategy with a bar-based time stop and an ATR-based stop loss. Head over to the retester module and choose the walk-forward matrix. I prefer floating or unanchored optimizations because these should do a better job at helping the strategy adapt to prevailing market conditions. The settings are similar to what you would get in a normal optimization, except that you get to select the optimization range for your walk-forward settings. I recommend optimizing the number of runs within the 10 to 30 range in steps of 5. OOS percent values will be optimized from 10 to 40 in steps of 10. This will give us a 20-cell matrix, with each cell corresponding to one WFO setting. For the parameter value distribution, I will set the maximum and minimum values to be 50% above and below the original, respectively, with 10 steps in total. To minimize the risk of curve fitting, only important parameters such as indicator periods and exit levels will be optimized. Now let's select the components of the robustness score. Similar to the original walk-forward optimization video, I'll look for a walk-forward efficiency or net profit stability of at least 50%. At least 70% of runs should be profitable, and no run should contribute more than half of the total profit. For the walk-forward matrix condition, I want a stable 9-cell region where at least 7 cells have a 100% robustness score, meaning all three conditions mentioned earlier are satisfied. A robust strategy should not only demonstrate strong out-of-sample performance across the data segments, but also across a broad range of walk-forward settings. The matrix here is looking pretty solid, with 17 of the 20 settings having a 100% robustness score. At the top, you can view the results of each of the walk-forward settings. For example, for 10 runs and a 30% out-of-sample setting, the walk-forward efficiency falls below our requirement of 50%. So which setting is optimal? There are multiple 9-cell regions in which at least 7 cells meet our performance criteria. It's a toss-up between these two cells here, but the highlighted cell with 20 runs and 20% out of sample has a slightly higher walk-forward efficiency and percentage of profitable runs, so the software has selected it for us. On the right, you can see the performance of each data segment. With this setting, we need to re-optimize the strategy every 246 days and apply the following parameters. Ideally, look for optimal parameters that do not fluctuate much, which is another sign of robustness. So that's how you can arrive at optimal walk-forward settings without compromising robustness. Do subscribe to keep the channel going. For a more in-depth explanation of what walk-forward optimization is, check out the video at the top right. To learn about Monte Carlo out-of-sample testing instead, check the video at the bottom.